to the world. Subscribe now to the Hot 97 YouTube channel. It's Ebro in the Morning with Laura Stiles and Rosenberg.
Rosenberg is on the chopping block in the hot seat. Well, they are outside the station with pitchforks.
That's not
the
true.
Kelly Rowland Hive wants you on a skewer, sir.
Well, here's the interesting thing about today's congrats is I gave it to myself an hour after the interview. When it was still being edited. Oh, when it was still being edited.
No, before. As soon as she walked out.
Oh, I said it to you right after she walked out?
Yes.
The second she left, I was like, I don't think I asked that question right. I think I messed up. Because she seemed upset during that. And I then sent her a message and was like, I'm really sorry. I did not mean to.
Oh, so you already hit yourself with the button?
Yeah, immediately.
Congratulations. You played yourself.
If you haven't seen the interview yet, it's up on YouTube, but essentially the way the question sounded, I was trying to ask her about, you know, thriving while having to deal with, you know, working with someone who's such a big star, right?
Mm.
I even tried to make a comparison to my personal life. Oh, me and Ebro, you know, working with people's a challenge and this. I tried, but guess what?
Nah, what you actually said was playing second fiddle to Ebro is terrible. That's what you actually said.
So, and people didn't like the terminology playing second.
Oh, got it.
That's what I think it was.
Because people took it as you're dismissing her success.
By the way, I was not remotely trying. Like, Kelly Rowland, to me, it's like so obvious that she's an iconic star that, like, I didn't think twice about bringing it up as a conversation. But in retrospect, I brought it up in a way that was clumsy, and I understand why people were annoyed by it. So hit me.
I played
with
myself.
Thank you.
Well, I'm not even sure Kelly was talking to you. I wasn't even convinced her energy was directed at you. I'm not quite, because in the moment, I was like, she's just kind of telling the world, right? And even in her explanation, it was like she was talking about, like, maturity and understanding what's, like, best for you, and it's not about comparing people. Your question wasn't about comparing them. Like, I don't even think she was specifically responding to what you had asked her about, which was thriving while being next to someone who is a tremendous superstar.
That was all I meant by it. And, like, I understand Kelly Rowland fans watch all of her interviews, and so, like, oh my God, why could someone bring this up? But for us, you have to understand, we interview a lot of people. You sit down with someone as awesome as Kelly Rowland, you get excited, and you go, oh, what are the things I've wanted to ask her? And I'm not thinking about the fact that she's heard that a million times. I also talk 8 hours a day, guys. I'm going to get it wrong sometimes. I don't like how
so
I
you're
asked
yourself
it.
With the button.
Hit the button again.
I played myself.
I just wanted a regular congratulations, but okay.
Oh, you can't get it. You want the Cali joint. Yeah. You want the official stamp.
You know Shawnee's going to give you a little extra.
You got to say you played yourself.
Congratulations. You played yourself.
But we'll let Cali
but
say
But that's
it
what
too.
The whole thing is.
Well, so, but also what's also happening here is, you know, it's the white man asking a beautiful black girl
talk that talk.
About what's going on with her.
How
Mine,
dare you?
Stay out of black folks' business, Rosenberg.
How dare you?
How
She's
dare
a brown light.
I mean, she is. She is absolutely that.
Yes, shining bright.
Let me tell you.
Shining.
She's shining. She is shining. Shout out to Kelly Rowland. No, I'm sorry.
I